So this is my unconventional garment for fashion class for my son. This is our agenda. So you may ask, what is an unconventional project? So it's using materials that we don't usually use for like the fashion industry. So like fabric and like stuff that you would use. So I used artificial roses, aluminum foil, and chicken wire, and regular wire. My original design, as you can see, was like a whole, like, this would be connected basically, and then it would go all the way to the ground. So it was like a whole ballroom dress. And it had pockets too. And I was originally gonna have glitter like going up as a like a gradient. And yeah, I had to change the length of the dress because I had to think about the structural design and how my model Lorraine, how she would walk up the stairs. And if like I had it all the way to the floor, she can't walk up the stairs. So I had to think about that. And I had to think about because since I was gonna have this connected the front, I couldn't because the way I had to bend it, it didn't allow me to, and then it didn't allow me to connect that in the back either. So like the back is open. So if I had it connected, it wouldn't bend the way I wanted to. So I had to change some things in order for Lorraine to wear it. And I didn't put pockets either because at the time, and like I didn't know how to like put the pockets in. So I just left it as is. The process was a very long process. It was like probably a month doing this. And I had to get the materials, which like as I said, chicken wire, artificial roses, tissue paper, and aluminum foil, and hot glue. So at first I didn't know how like I was gonna do this. So I started off with the top and I did like this triangle top because you never see like a dress with a triangle top, like, so I wanted to do something different. So I did that and I left the back open because I didn't know what to do in the back. And but at first I was gonna have the front, like the triangle in the back too, but it was just gonna take up too much time. And then again, the structural problems too. So I just left it open. And the formation after I got the materials was like hard. Hmm. Like I literally put my blood and sweat. Like literally my blood. Like I stabbed myself so many times. So I had to ask Miss Young, like this part around the breast area, how would I bend it and make it form-fitting? Because if you make it form-fitting, it fits more and it's more easier to like fit my model, which is Lorraine. So I had to make, well, you don't see it now, I had to make holes and like form it to a triangle on the breast area so it could bend correctly. And then for it to close back here, I had to make that triangle, as you can see right here, in order for it to close. And what I learned about myself is I can't stick to one thing. I had this vision, which was the original design. I couldn't stick to it. I had to change my idea. I had to change like pretty much like half of the things that I wanted to do. But I was okay with it, cause like in the future I'm not really gonna like have this one way. I have to go different ways in order to get where I have to go. And I have to have plan B's, plan C's, you know, like plan D's and, you know, even E's. So this was my like plan, like 100, I don't know, like this is what it came out to right here. And I think it'll help me for my future job that I want to do. I want to start my own business. So I know starting my own business, I'm not going to have that plan A go off like right away. So I'm going to have to have a lot of backups. And it prepared me to like understand that not everything's gonna go my way. So if I had time to revise it and edit it, I think I would ask for more time. Because if I had more time, I would have had time to figure out how to actually make it connect and had time to actually figure out the things that I wanted to do that I didn't do. like making it go down and be able to go up the stairs with it being all over the floor. But I think it still came out well. And I also wanted to cover the whole, like, the whole dress in flowers. But that didn't work out because I ran out of flowers and the time is showing too. So instead right here, I put aluminum foil so it could cover it, so I could give that industrial look. Then I put tissue paper so it looks full, but it's not too full.
Any questions?
The wearability of it, how do you think it's going to be?
I measured it on Lorraine a couple of times. The first time, I only had the top, and I had to like fix some of the wiring because it was like poking her because I didn't realize it. So I fixed it to have all the wires facing out instead of in. And then I also put hot glue. You can't really see it, but I put hot glue on any wiring that was sticking out so it doesn't hurt her. And then for the bottom, I did the same thing too, because right here, all the wires were sticking up, so it would pinch her on her by her waist. So I put hot glue everywhere, all the way around, so it's like a gel, like covering, so it won't hurt her.
Did you think about like adding some type of lining in the inside to help with that?
Maybe
spandex or
I was, but again with like
the timing. Yeah.
I was gonna like add newspaper like literally like all the way around so it doesn't poke anybody. But then you know the timing. So I just added aluminum foil because I didn't have time to like actually like do the things I wanted to do. So the aluminum foil is like newspaper, so it's like it covers this in some ways. And then again I put hot glue like everywhere.
Do you think she'll be able to sit in it?
No. I don't know. I didn't do that test where you could sit. But, you know, she could walk. She could go up the stairs. She could, like, wear it comfortably. And then, like, another problem I had was, like, as you can see, the latches to get in and out of it. It took me, like, a whole week to find out how to do it because I didn't know exactly how to do it and how to keep it closed. So what I did was I took some of the wiring and I put it, like, as little hooks that you see on dresses. And then some of it wasn't working, so I just put little tiny baby clips so I could take it in and out, so she could send it. And then in the back, I did the same thing too. So I have a little hook where it closes. So like, if anybody wants to wear it, like they have enough room to make it bigger or smaller.
Ah, so it's size adjustable.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Cool. I love this piece. I think it's really, really awesome. And every time I walk into the art room to like cover for Miss Young, I'm like amazed by it. And I'm curious about how you got the idea for like the little tissue paper flowers.
Oh, because I don't know. Like you don't really see dresses with like actual flowers.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to do something different and like go for like the whole nature vibe,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Mm-hmm.
And like I had this inspiration from my mom's house. She has like this flower arrangement. And I was like, oh, it would be cool to make a flower out of dresses. I mean, not dresses, out of roses. So I just ordered fake roses and then like covered the whole thing. And like, I feel like it came out the way
you envisioned.
I somewhat envisioned it.
It's great.